the communion table offers us is another opportunity to cleanse up our life, to examine your life again. You need to keep examining your life every time you come to the communion table. You look into your life and see whether there is anything evil. To the best of your knowledge, is there anything that you did against somebody that this person is not happy with you? You ignore it and you come to the communion table. Examine your life. That's why the Bible says, lie not to one another. Defraud not one another. Cheat not one another. If you do it, the consequences is the Lord. These are the truths that are not being told in the body of Christ. You are sleeping with somebody that is not legally married with you in the presence of God. Be careful. You have a lot, all kinds of lust inside of your heart. Be careful. When you come to this communion table, look into your life. Is there anything wrong? Because you see, if you do so, and you look at your life and you repent and make sure your heart is clean, you are going to live a healthy life. You are going to live a long life. You are going to live a prosperous life. The power of God, the ability, there is a lot of power inherent here. God made a covenant between you and Himself. He said, I will never leave you nor forsake you. I will be with you till the end of the age. In the time of trouble, call upon me. I will answer you. I am there for you. But what is the problem? We are practicing anti-covenant laws. Anti-covenant practices. That is why the benefits of the new covenant that we have, we are not actualizing them. We are not experiencing them. We are not seeing them happen in our life.